This is Marie from Underground Crafter, and welcome to another Tips Tuesday. This is part two of my series on traveling with your crocheting or knitting. So I'm going to be sharing three tips today that are going to make it much easier to travel with your favorite hobby. And so let's go jump right into them. By the way, if you missed last week's episode, I'll have a link to that in the notes below the video. And you'll be able to find out my tips for finding great yarn shops while you're on vacation or traveling for business or whatever reason that you're away from home. Okay, so my first tip is to get the right supplies. Now, if you're traveling by plane, generally speaking, you want to be cautious about different, your bag is going to have to go through the scanner and all that. And of course, there's only certain things you can bring on planes. So what I always recommend is for your crochet hooks, your knitting needles are to bring wood or plastic hooks or needles rather than metal if possible. And even though for the most part metal hooks and needles are allowed, sometimes you might get somebody from the Transportation Safety Administration going through your bags and they may not feel comfortable with that. So what I usually bring are my Denise To Go kit, and I'll show you this. This is the crochet one with two hooks. I have actually many of these. I will say that I did get this one free from the Denise folks, but I have many, many sets because I'm a longtime user. And what I like about these is there's two hooks in each size, and there's also a bunch of cords, so I can make a regular crochet hook, a double-ended crochet hook, or a Tunisian crochet hook, and they have a set like this for knitting as well, so you can make straight needles or circular needles. And this is perfect for traveling because it's really small, but it has a lot of sizes. And I think we all know that once we get away from home, suddenly we need the size we don't have. So I do like that it bundles up and it's plastic, which is great. So having the right hooks is a big part of it. Safety scissors. So I don't bring regular scissors with me. I bring these children's safety scissors with the rounded edges. Again, just to make everybody feel comfortable. And actually, oftentimes you are not allowed to bring those pointy snips like that embroiderers might use. So safety scissors are good. You can get them at the drugstore or any craft store. I also have a tiny little bag, and this is just a cute little bag that I got in a swap one time, but you can use any kind of small little bag that I always keep aside with all my travel stuff. And that's because when I'm traveling, I don't want to have to remember to pack all this. So you can kind of look in here and see what's going on, or maybe you can't. Oh, there you can. So what I always have is a gauge ruler. So this one is from Knit Picks. And this allows me to measure my gauge. It also has a needle check if you want to make sure what size needles you have, but I don't usually bring needles that don't have sizes on them. I bring a little set of needles, so if I need to weave in any ends, I have all different kinds of needles in here. And I do pack the ones that are, again, not with the pointed edges like for sewing, but yarn needles with the blunt tips. And I keep them in this little case so they don't fall out during my trip. And I also bring stitch markers in my little travel bag. And this is, I use the locking stitch markers so they can be used for knit or crochet. And you'll notice with all of these things, these are relatively inexpensive items that could be easily replaced if my bag gets stolen. So I'm not going to keep in my to-go kit my best stitch markers that are handmade or anything like that. And of course, a pen, because you might need to write down a pattern or make some changes. So that's all in my safety kit. You may want to consider, if you're a knitter, also including point protectors to cover your knitting needle points. Again, partially to ease the folks at the airport their feelings, and also because you don't want to lose your project if you have to get up in the middle of something. So having point protectors can be helpful. The other thing I always suggest is, if you are flying especially, this doesn't matter as much if your trip is by car or train or bus, but if you're flying, always start the project before you leave home, whatever you're going to have in your carry-on bag. It just makes the people feel more comfortable. So it's not like you just have a big array of knitting needles, but you have a couple of rows on there so they feel like, okay, this person is really knitting and they're not bringing some kind of strange weapon onto the plane. And the same for crochet. So again, I do start a little bit of a project at home just to kind of, you know, show that it's real. And again, my little travel bag, what I do with this is I keep this stacked. I don't keep the hooks in there because I love them and I use them for other projects, but I keep all the, you know, other stuff in there. And then when I have a trip, I just drop in the yarn and the hooks that I want. Or I can drop this into a bigger project bag, but it has all of those supplies that are just a little bit harder to to get while you're on the road. So that's the first thing, is having the right supplies. So my next tip is to make your hobby part of your trip. And you can really catch the video from last week, which I'll have a link to that in the comments, that gives you a lot more details on how to do this. But I highly recommend visiting a yarn shop or a fiber festival or any kind of yarn related event or place while you're in town. It's a great way to meet locals, and it's a great way to relax, and it's a great way to get a wonderful souvenir from your trip. Hopefully some yarn or something special from the store that you can't get back home. And even if you can get it back home, it'll remind you of that trip. So that's my second part, is make your hobby part of your trip. Now here's my third part, and this is really the most important one, and this is the one I have the hardest time following, and this is to choose the right projects. So I don't know if I'm the only one, but I always have this idea that I'm going to finish so much while I'm traveling, and I pack, you know, like 75 balls of yarn, and then I use two or something. And I do always get a lot of crocheting and knitting done while I'm traveling, because there's so much time when you have a lot of time to do things with your hands, but within reason. So here's my suggestions for you. First, think about what you're actually going to be doing on this trip before you start loading yarn into your bag. So are you going to be spending a lot of time alone? If that's the case, then maybe you might actually get more projects done. Are you going to be spending a lot of time with friends and family? If you're going to be spending a lot of time with friends and family, you might want to pick a project that's a little bit easier so you can be chatting while you're working on it. So not something that's super complex and that you're going to be, have to be totally focused on, because of course you won't pick that up at all if you're hanging out with friends and family. Are you going to be yarn shopping while you're on your trip? Which I highly recommend. If you are, remember to bring a bunch of different crochet hooks or knitting needle sizes, because then you can get your project started right away as soon as you come out of the store. What about patterns? So I usually recommend what I do when I'm traveling is I print my patterns on like kind of recycled paper left over from something else. Again, if I lose it, it's not a nightmare. It's not the original pattern. I don't carry books with me, really. If you have some kind of mobile device or a Kindle or anything like that, you can also save your patterns on there. That can help too, because you're just not packing as many things. So that's what I do for patterns usually. I either print them out or I save them actually onto my Kindle, and then I just work from there. And that way I don't have to bring books or other big things with me. You can also write them down. I have written stuff out in a notebook when it's just a stitch that I'm working on. Like let's say if I'm working on a blanket or a scarf that's just one stitch pattern that's a couple of rows, I might not even bring a whole big piece of paper. I might just include it in a little notepad that I would be taking with me anyway. So, I mean, that's another thing to think about with patterns. But to go back to the original part of this, which is not overpacking, be realistic about what you're going to be doing on your trip before you start loading up your suitcase. Because by the time you come back, those 17 extra balls of yarn are going to be pretty heavy. And hopefully you're going to add some new ones from your travels as well. So I would recommend packing light. For me, what I find is that I do get a lot of smaller projects finished, but when I bring a big project, I don't usually get that much done. So what I usually do is I bring a couple of single skeins of yarn so that I can work on smaller projects like hats and things like that while I'm on the road. So I hope these tips have helped you. Again, having the right supplies, the ones that are gonna not cause you any problems as you go in and out of security if you're flying, or also just if you lose them at some point on your trip, it's not gonna be a big nightmare, including your hobby as part of your trip. So having fun with knitting or crocheting or yarn activities while you're traveling. And again, you can refer back to last week's episode for more information about how to do that. And then being, kind of common sense about your projects. And this one's the hardest for me too. So if you can't do it, it's totally okay. You're in good company. But doing your best not to overpack in terms of yarn and to be realistic about the kind of projects you realistically can complete. So again, if you're mostly going to be by yourself, those are probably going to be more complicated projects. If you're mostly going to be with other people, those are probably going to be the simpler projects that you can chat and put down and not have to worry about messing up. So I hope you've enjoyed these tips for making your traveling with your crocheting and knitting a little bit easier. Oh, in the comments, if you can share your own favorite tips for what you do when you're traveling with your crocheting and knitting, that would be great. And don't forget to subscribe on YouTube or follow on Facebook. Thanks so much!